posture, grip, and aim are alignment. And I just tell the kids when it comes to posture to make sure they just kind of get into a ready athletic position. And that doesn't mean a whole lot to a lot of kids. I try to relate that. Have you played a different sport? What have you done? So that they can relate to something that could be related to golf, but my job is to get to know what sports they like, what is it something I can make them feel more comfortable doing. But as they get into the posture, it's just an athletic position, but I get them to line up. And in first tee, I use this triangle here, where I get the younger ones to make the letter A. They can all figure that out. The A doesn't look good from there, or over here, they can usually kind of get a pretty good letter A. In their setup, I get them to make the letter V. Through the arms and with the club, it makes the letter Y. And in the swing, quite often I'll just get them to swing waist high to waist high, or can they keep the Y all the way through? That will move. Because if they can get good at that and make some contact, that's really a good place to start. When it comes to holding onto the golf club, and I will share the story of it because it just happened. I got myself in a little bit of trouble the other day. Not serious, but I'm a big believer that you just clap your hands together, the thumb fits in right here, and I said that it's like making a hot dog. You put the wiener and you pull it up with the bun. I was told, you cannot say that, Coach Dale. Not by one of the other coaches. I got it from one of the students. So we just build a hot dog now. We don't put the wiener anywhere. Just wieners. Kevin's shaking his head at me now. It was an embarrassing moment for me. I knew what I did there. So I shared that because as coaches, make sure that you did not use. I will be the guinea pig on that one. So creating the hot dog, or I always just put the thumb inside the middle of that hand. I put my feet together, just kind of create my triangle or my A. Create my Y, I lean forward. And that's kind of what it is, the simplicity of that, without trying to say, you know, this V's got to do this, and this got to do this, you make a widget. Keep it super simple. They're there just to make contact with the ball. I do a little drill lots of times where I'll get the kids just to hit the tee. Get them to hit it three times in a row before we even let them hit ball one. Keeping it super simple. I work on positions with them lots of times. Josh and I have done this many times. We just finished up our clinics, and it's really quite humorous. I'll get kids to go to position one, and they know their setup position. Two and three is all the way up here. Four is impact, and five is all the way through. And I'll go, position one, two, three, four, five. And I can guarantee you that I've taught kids through our summer camps, through first tee, at any point in time, you can bring the class back in, because there's times you lose the class a little bit. Bring them back in to do that. Position one, everybody. You go, two, three, four, five. And part of it is getting them more comfortable holding their golf club. They can put a ball down there. When we work on balance sometimes, Josh and I will get them to hit balls with their eyes closed with those positions. It's a great little balance drill. But I wanted to go over some of that technique. It's really simple in the beginning. Your job isn't to, you're not quite shifting your weight. All this looks like, it's not your job. If you can help them, great. But overall, remember, it's not always about that result. It's about helping that person make a better shot, a better contact. Any questions?
For me, to you?
Or in general?
Just things to say. No, I think Dave's right. Just keeping it simple, it helps with your confidence. If you have extra knowledge, definitely apply it. I think the best way to apply your knowledge to someone else is letting the students know, this is what works for me. It may not work for you, but go ahead and give it a try, right? Because even if they fail, you don't want them to be discouraged. You want them to go and try something new with some confidence, right? It's okay. So for me, I always say, this is what either my coach has taught me or this is what works well for me. Would you like to try it? Or I'd like to tell kids, I'm gonna weird you out. and I weird you out real fast. And they're like, huh? Right? And it just gets them in a state of mind, and they're like, okay. Because it's going to feel uncomfortable for them to try something new, and that's okay. I think in 2015, my New Year's resolution was being comfortable, being uncomfortable, right? Putting yourself in those situations where you don't have control of it. It feels weird. It's totally cool. Enjoy being in that space, right? And let the kids enjoy being in that space. Your facilitators, you're here to encourage the kids to have fun. Like Dave said, golf's a game. It's meant to be enjoyed. We're here just to make sure the kids are safe and that they're being encouraged in a positive way.
So, you talked about it's not about the result, it's about having fun, it's about the process.
Yeah.
We all get that. However, every kid comes in with a to be doing. In fact, maybe they even had a conversation with their parents about, boy, you want to be doing this, hitting it far, whatever. So we've all seen kids where they're not getting the results that they think they should be getting. We try to be positive, but I'm just curious, what have you learned? What are some things that you find work really well when a child is just struggling with the fact that they're not getting the result, even though we tell them it's not about the result, it's about the process?
Well, sometimes, depending on the size of the child, whether they're this tall or this tall, because we're all just big kids. I don't know if anyone here is usually happy with the results they're getting. And that's very general. But so the key is, how can I simplify that to build their confidence up so that they are hitting it? And I'll say, can you do that in a smaller scale? If you were a runner, you're not going to run 26 miles for... So can they actually get good at hitting the ball from here to there? And that I might have to come up with a game. I'll do it with adults lots of times. I'll say, if you were to take a trip anywhere in the world, where would you go? And who would you take with you? And then I'll say, so now can you do that, hit that tee three times in a row? And, or if it's a golf ball for me, I'll say the golf ball's right out there in a certain place. That's where the keys are to that trip. That's where the tickets are to that trip. Can you do that? Because if they can't do that, I know I can't. Even if they take a full swing and hit it good, they're just going to tell themselves they got lucky.
So give them something simple that they can do and
correct.
Reinforce that.
Absolutely. So I'm building the confidence up to build them up in that area that they can get to where they want to go.
Good. Josh.
Yeah. Also, too, if you're having that, you can always make that connection, whatever level they're in, every level, I think, I don't know if Target does, but they're all dealing with challenges, right? So if it's either through the 4 R's, through STAR, through CARE, you know, or core value, perseverance, right? You may not be doing it, but that's why we teach them life skills, right? And you make that connection with them. Just have them, don't give up. Just try, keep on trying. You may not get it today. You may not even get it over the next 8 weeks of your class. But you're here for the big picture. And I think that's, as coaches, the hard part is making connections with their life skills to their golf skills. That's just you using your own personal experiences and things that are comfortable for you to share with the kids. And, you know, once again, it's not always about golf for me.
So I went to a couple of range clinics this winter.
Can't hear you.
Went to a couple of the range clinics this winter, and then with them into a couple of locations this week. And I noticed some kids, I think they struggled a little bit with finding that athletic position. I would ask them, if they played other sports like baseball, softball, tennis. I'm just curious, just kind of going through the thought process, have you found that focusing on the athletic position without the club?
Without the club,
is that beneficial to them? Like, just, maybe trying to throw a ball underhand, just getting in that position?
You know what, the answer to your question is yes. And I'll do it different ways, because if they played basketball, baseball, it's that ready athletic position. I find out what they've done, or if they played basketball, that defensive position, just somewhere in close. And then from a technique perspective, because I try my best to get them involved in something they already know, is I'll just get them to put their feet together, put a 90-degree angle, put their feet about hip-width apart, then lean forward at the waist. Just a little bit. And then I may walk up behind them, just go like this and finding a balanced position. Say, you know what? That's really good. How does that feel? And most of the kids will say, oh, I could do this. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's, I don't know if I answered your question.
No, you did, because I kind of got the feeling like they understand that little position, but then you can put the club in their hands and the length of it. but correct. It doesn't fit them perfectly, and then that really just kind of...
So that's when I would just kind of give them one of these and go,
yeah.
How does that feel? Now, the other thing, Coach D, when you have a young person who's not getting the results they want, which is pretty much all the time, it's real important because it usually has nothing to do with golf, of what it is. It's a bigger life skill. And one of the things I've found to get to know them better is I get down at their level and talk to them eye to eye. Because all of a sudden they just feel like there's a situation that, you know, and say, you know, is this really, you know, how important is it to you to hit that tee? And I, because I want to help you get where you want to go. But talk to them at their level. Lots of times I'll be on my knees teaching golf lessons. People say, what are you doing on your knees? I said, well, I'm just talking to the people I'm working with because this is the level they're at. Because all of a sudden I don't want to be talking down to them all the time when they're, it's okay most of the time, but you go down and go, you create a different relationship with them when we're eye to eye. Because we know how to shake hands, we know how to take our hat off and look them in the eye. Speaking to them on that level is also very good. Yes.
What if they haven't done anything athletic or something like that? What if they've never played any other sports?
I just tell them to go find Evan. In that particular case, I asked them why they're here. Just, I want to learn something. They said, great, it might not be as easy, but you know, we're going to make it fun. Can you just have fun doing it and you do the best you can with whatever it is in that case? Did that answer your question?
Oh, yeah, I was going to say, sometimes with new students, it's your terminology that you use. A word I like to use, especially when you're starting new, right? I always like to start on the putting green, work my way out. It helps with confidence. Putting's the easiest stroke to make. As coaches, I would advise you to use this word when you're telling your kids to putt. You do not hit a ball with the putter. You roll the ball. Just the word roll makes that motion smaller and smoother. To hit is to whack, right? So think about the words you use in relation to what the outcome you want from that certain golf skill, right? And I think that can be huge too.
I think one thing that you mentioned, Dave, was playing games.
Yes.
And I found that even some of my older students love animal golf. So it's like if they're not seeing the results, the number one thing with the first tee is it focuses on components. So like today we worked on balance, and I was the student, and Dean, I had a bad shot, and Dean said good balance. So reinforce the positive, and that helps build confidence with those pieces. But also, I think if you're not connecting on the golf level, make it about an animal, you know, be a bat. What, how would a bat swing a golf club, you know, and give him lots of room for it?
Can I watch?
But that could actually, you know, help them with balance. If they're a bat, they're closing their eyes. What are they thinking? You know, what's your vision? Are you seeing, you know, yourself being Tiger Woods? You know, how would you swing a golf club? So make it fun and not necessarily about the result.
Okay.
What
are we doing time-wise?
35.
Any other questions?
Evan says we're done.
Getting cold.
So if you do have any questions.